Hi everybody, this is Judy at Judy in the Kitchen. I've got some quick tips and ideas for you today on what to do with butternut squash, so hopefully this will help you out. Butternut squash can be a little challenging to peel, and to make it easier to peel before you cook it, you could microwave the whole thing for 2 or 3 minutes first. That'll soften it up a little bit and make it easier to peel. Now the peel of butternut squash is edible, but we know it's tough. So if you really want to eat the peel, you can slow roast the squash and the peel will get softer as it roasts. Then you can do what you want with the peel. For something a little different, try butternut squash fries instead of potato fries. How about topping salads with cubes of roasted butternut squash? That would be good. How about adding chunks of butternut squash to your favorite stew? Try stuffing a roasted butternut squash half with a mixture of cooked grains of your choice and vegetables for a delicious and filling side dish. How about adding roasted butternut squash to breakfast for something a little different? Add thin slices of raw butternut squash to salads for some added flavor and some crunch. Enjoy roasted butternut squash in place of potatoes, pumpkin, or even sweet potato. Try mashed, cooked butternut squash with a little milk of your choice and some cinnamon and serve it instead of mashed potatoes, something a little different. Try pureed butternut squash in place of pumpkin when you're making pies or tarts. Add cooked butternut squash to pasta dishes, or you can puree it and make an interesting sauce to go on your pasta. Combine pureed butternut squash with coconut milk and make a creamy squash soup. That sounds rich and delicious. Butternut squash seeds are edible. Okay, you can save them and roast them just as you would pumpkin seeds. Once you scoop them out, you want to separate the seeds from that stringy pulp, and then you want to rinse them well. You can coat them with a little bit of oil, season them as you want, spread them out in a single layer on parchment paper lined baking sheet or foil lined baking sheet. Roast them at about 225 Fahrenheit for about 15 minutes until the seeds start to pop. Then you want to allow them to cool just a little bit before you serve them so you don't get burned. Do you want to enjoy some pureed squash but you're not quite sure how to flavor it? Try sprinkling pureed butternut squash with a little cinnamon and maple syrup. That would be good, almost like a dessert. For an interesting side dish, you could steam cubes of butternut squash, toss them with a little bit of olive oil, soy sauce, and ginger. Sprinkle some toasted squash seeds for a little bit of crunch, and there you have a nice side dish. Well, I do hope this helps. If you have other ideas that you like to do with butternut squash, share them with others. It'll help. This is Judy at Judy in the Kitchen. Bye for now.